Joining us right now, six-year NFL veteran. He's played with number one overall pick Eli Manning and number one overall pick Sam Bradford. And now, top pick in this year's draft, Kyler Murray. Please welcome back friend of the show, Justin Pugh, to the building. What's up, baby?
Thanks for having me on. Doing well. Living in the city for the summer, training, getting ready for, training camp after OTAs.
Okay.
Decided to stop by. I just came by to see the view. I heard it was next level.
Well, how is it? You like it so far?
Unbelievable. Yeah, I'm just going to hang out.
Let me ask you about the view in AZ, though. The Cardinals. I mean, there's a new look, new team, new feel, new coach, new QB. How you feeling about your new squad?
I love it. I mean, it's a great group of guys out there. Obviously, the results on the field last year weren't where they needed to be. But you know how the NFL is. I was on a New York Giants team that went 11-5, won a lot of close games. Got better, and then was the worst team in the NFL. Mm. So you know how quickly the thing can turn around. And you get a great player in the draft. You bring in some guys, get some guys healthy. I'm excited about this season.
You mentioned Kyler Murray there.
Yeah.
I heard from something that you said earlier this offseason, he brought donuts in to sort of endear himself to you guys. It's very savvy, very smart way to get to your O-lineman in their heart. What are your first sort of, what do you think of Kyler at first, meeting him over the past couple of days?
This is the first offseason I felt like a veteran. I had some of the guys come in and they said, in eighth grade, I had you on my Madden team. And now I'm like, I go to Larry. I'm like, Larry, how do you feel about this? If they were in eighth grade when I was getting drafted, these guys might not be, weren't even alive.
Larry was on the Sega.
Yeah, exactly. But no, they've been awesome so far. We have a great rookie class. Kyler's been unbelievable. The things he can do, there's very few guys. I mean, Odell Beckham comes to mind with just natural, God-given ability.
Wow.
He can make every throw. And he's one of those guys where when he makes a play, everyone just stops and stares. I mean, there's times where I just catch myself. I need to be doing my job. And I'm like, wow, that was a good little.
Ooh, I like that.
Yeah.
Love hearing that.
Fantasy alert. For me, it's what's the mindset of this team, right? New coach, new quarterback, a lot of young pieces. Is it win now or is it build for the future?
I think it's always win now. I mean, you have guys that have been there before. You have Larry Fitzgerald has that veteran leadership. You have Patrick Peterson. You never go into a season like, hey, we're just going to build for the next year. If you look at any, a lot of these rookie quarterbacks have had success. You look at Wentz down in Philadelphia. You look at Russell Wilson in Seattle. RG3's rookie year, everyone forgets. I mean, they were in the playoffs that
fantastic
first year. So I think for us, obviously, getting into the playoffs is the goal. And we have a lot of exciting energy, a lot of things going on, and I'm looking forward to having a great year.
Now, you play with great quarterbacks, but also great receivers. I mean, Larry Fitzgerald, Odell Beckham. I want to ask you to choose, but what are a couple of qualities that you see in these two individuals?
Work ethic. If you come watch them practice, you'll feel like you're in that game environment. There's not a ball. Larry Fitzgerald is still diving for balls. I mean, he's one of the best guys to be around on the field, off the field. Larry Fitzgerald just does it right. And then, obviously, I had Odell in New York. Victor Cruz was one of the first guys that came into the NFL with me.
Yeah.
Victor was another great receiver.
Yeah.
So I've been blessed to be around a lot of great receivers and a lot of great men. I mean, Larry is one of those guys you just kind of watch how he works, and you try to emulate that on and off the field.
You've also been blessed, or I guess you could say blessed, to play against like the best defensive player in the NFL in Aaron Donald. You have some experience with him, and you take him on twice a year. So take me on the field. On the field, what is it like to face Aaron Donald?
You look at Aaron Donald and you're like, you're not impressed. I mean, when you look at him on the field in pads, because you can't see that he's...
It's a good quote. Get that out there. Not impressed.
You can't see like he's 300 pounds and has a six-pack. Like,
you
follow him on Instagram, you're like, oh, wow, this is a whole different animal. But like, stature-wise, you don't think anything too crazy.
Yeah.
And then he comes off the ball and he's the most as explosive as any defensive tackle, defensive lineman, period.
Yeah.
He's a game changer. He's by far the best D lineman. I've had to go against him since he was at Pittsburgh.
Mm.
I went to Syracuse
at
Pittsburgh.
No.
And they had him at defensive end at first. And I was, you're in college and not many guys gave me too much of an issue. I didn't know if I was any. And then you go against a guy like Aaron Donald and you're like, wow.
Yeah.
This guy's on a whole nother level. And then for some reason, I said, you know what? Let me sign up to play against him twice a year.
Why not?
I said, let's do it.
Smart.
Hey, you always compete. So this, earlier this month, you had your youth football camp.
Yeah.
Tell us all about it.
I think any guy in the NFL, once you realize the platform that we're on, the ability we have to impact kids, my mom was a sixth grade teacher for 34 years, and I would always go back and talk to her kids, talking about setting goals, trying to build towards those things. And you go back and they tell you the goals they had written down. So you realize the impact we have on young children. So I decided to come back and do a camp every year. It's been awesome. We've done it for 5 straight years, and we just keep getting bigger, growing, and getting it down right. And it's a blast to go back and be involved, because I was that kid at some point. So I just want to let them know, hey, whatever's going on, you can achieve what you want.
Love awesome. That you're making an impact on and off the field. Justin Pugh, come back anytime. You are a super friend of the show.
Thank you very
Good
much.
Luck
I
this year.
It.